Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Because of its speedy revolution around our sun, Mercury is the most elusive of the naked eye visible planets, because it requires knowing when and where to look. And the window of visibility is short, not only on any given day, but also for the short few days it remains visible before passing behind or between the sun and Earth. To top that off, other factors complicate observations from Earth. Sometimes the angle of the ecliptic makes for a shallow distance above the horizon, causing the sun's glare to overwhelm the brightness of the planet. Other times, the somewhat more elliptical orbit of Mercury keeps the planet from climbing very high above the horizon at all, even at its greatest elongation from our perspective. But the next 2 weeks are different. First, although the ecliptic is not as steep as it could be, in late evening it points higher into the sky than if we were viewing in the morning sky at the same time of year. Secondly, take a look at where Mercury is in its orbit and where Earth is in relation to it. Notice the greater distance away from the sun for Mercury. This indicates it will climb higher in our sky than it would if it were closer to the sun on, say, the other side of its orbit. And lastly, notice that there is another planet in the same line of sight, the brilliant Venus. Due to the highly reflective nature of the carbon dioxide clouds there, the sun's light creates a dazzling cosmic searchlight for us, which is located a few degrees away from the smaller and dimmer Mercury these weeks, giving us a conveniently located lighthouse to guide us. The added bonus is that Mercury will display a phase, so naked eye, binoculars, and telescopic observing will all be appropriate for this particular time frame. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Want to do something about light pollution but aren't sure how to get started? The International Dark Sky Association has a sample letter you can send to neighbors and tips on talking to them. Follow these guides and start working to reduce light pollution in your neighborhood, starting this week as you share views of Mercury. Back on the 26th of May, Jupiter, Venus, and Mercury all formed a lovely triangle in the western evening sky that won't be seen again for another 13 years. As Jupiter sank towards the horizon, Mercury sped ahead of Venus, and the innermost planet continues that trek this week. Although greatest elongation, its highest point above the horizon, does not occur until June 12th, Mercury visibly slows its ascent by the end of this week, ending about 5 degrees east of Venus. So when the sky darkens in the evening, about 30 to 45 minutes past sunset, look for Venus first. Then cast your gaze east along the ecliptic, 3 finger widths held at arm's length, to measure 5 degrees to try and spy Mercury. The celestial assist here is due to Mercury being higher in the sky than Venus, so the brighter planet will be lower, meaning less atmosphere will hinder Mercury's light to our eyes. Seeing both in binoculars will be easiest early in the week, as the two separate by 5 degrees later on. However, the treat is Mercury's phase. Though it offers no surface detail for ground-based telescopes, aiming one at Mercury at 150 times magnification or more should reveal a phase similar to a half moon, albeit much smaller. Though initially just under 7 arc seconds in diameter, this phase will increase to 10 arc seconds over the next 3 weeks, as Mercury moves towards inferior conjunction between the Sun and Earth. Try spotting this elusive planet this week or next. There won't be an opportunity this good again until the early morning hours in November. Mars is still too close to the sun to see, but Saturn remains well placed for evening and early morning observing. With the moon at new phase on June 8th, this is a great week to view Messier 5 and Messier 13 after the evening planets have set. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.